Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us for today's webinar. This is Suman Ramamurthy. Today's topic is BIM roadmap for architects and engineers, hosted by GBB Consulting Service Private Limited. Building information modeling, BIM, is an integrated process of generating and managing a building by exploring a digital model before the actual project is constructed, and later during its construction, facility operation, and maintenance. BIM has been adopted by engineers and architects in India to improve the planning and management of construction projects. This webinar will have experts from the industry share their insights. First, I would like to introduce Anirban Bhattacharjee. He is the BIM manager at Virtual Building Studio, who will be moderating the panel. Anirban has a total experience of 10 years in BIM industry, especially working on site in USA with the MCOR group. In addition to this, he has worked for 5 years on site in Qatar and Saudi Arabia in iconic construction project, which involved a paramount in BIM implementation of likes of Kingdom Tower and Sang Hospital in KSA. And we have Ankit Kansara. He is the CEO of Virtual Building Studio, a gold medalist architect with an experience of 15 years working extensively in UK, USA, and Middle East. He's also the first generation entrepreneur and CEO of Virtual Building Studio. He has worked on site in UK and Malaysia with an extensive emphasis on technology implementation and addition of value to architects with the usage of BIM. Also, we have Sonak Banerjee, who is a BIM consultant and technology analyst with an overall experience of 8 years in BIM and construction industry. He has been working in UAE for more than 3 years with one of the most prestigious architect, Zaha Hadid, and has been associated with many complex and mixed development projects. He has been associated with many owners in the complete BIM cycle from design to facility management. Over to you, Anirban.
Yes, good afternoon, everybody. We are very privileged to get the opportunity from GBV Ventures to organize this webinar today. And myself, Anirban Bhattacharjee, I'm representing Virtual Building Studio. I'm the BIM manager of the Virtual Building Studio. I invite all the respected and distinguished panelists, all the respected and distinguished guests who have joined this webinar. And let's start the webinar. So our today's topic is like BIM roadmap for architects and engineers. So in the today's discussion, the total discussion will be on that how BIM is instrumental or helpful for architecture and engineer, and is helpful from construction standpoint, from concept design till facilities management. Along with me, we have Mr. Ankit. He's the CEO of Virtual Building Studio, and Saunak Banerjee. He is a BIM consultant. He is in UAE, and he has worked extensively in projects in Middle East, and he was associated with a very prestigious Dubai Expo project, that Museum of Future. So in the course of this discussion, we'll be having a very good interactive session as well. So I will request Suman to drive away. We have a small presentation of our company, that how we are working with the architects, engineers, and the contractors. So Suman, can you please play the video? Yes. So this is the presentation of our company, that we are Virtual Building Studios. We are working in 360 degree AEC services. Our vision is to make digital transformation in BIM industry. We are working in 2D, 3D, 4D, and up to 7D, from concept design till facilities management. And we are doing scan to BIM services, clash coordination, and content creation as well. The next slide, please. Huh. The next slide, huh. Yes. So this is our journey. We have started in 2014, and we have a good experience of 7 years and collective experience of 15 years working in the global industry. Massively, we have our massive global footprints in the USA, UK, Singapore, Malaysia, and Middle East. We are working with very prestigious and iconic projects, and along with very prestigious company listed in stock exchange. This is as Mr. Ankit's picture is there. So he's the first generation entrepreneur of the company and the owner of the company. And he has been very instrumental in setting up the BIM platform, the digital transformation platform in the BIM industry. The next slide, Suman. Yes, this is the organization structure that what we are working. So this is the hierarchy that has been set up with the total engineers, architects, modelers, how the organization is set up with support team as well. Next slide. We are working massively in healthcare, sports arena, universities, airports, residentials, entertainment, retail facilities, hospitality. The total life cycle of construction we are operating, and these are some of our very prestigious clients that we have worked with. Along with this, we have worked in very prestigious projects in the Middle East. I want to tell someone, yes, this is the built design and build that we are doing. The total life cycle of BIM has been shown here, that how it can be very instrumental for architects and engineers to use this system, that the integrating the disciplines together, taking BOQs out of it, the quantity takeoffs, the cost studies, the area comparisons. Next slide. Okay, these are some iconic projects that we have done in US and Middle East. So next. So I'll just quickly roll the slide so that we can go to this. Yes. So these are the projects that we have done in Malaysia, Singapore, the scan to BIM services in Saudi Arabia as well, a very prestigious project in Qatar for the Qatar defense. So these are the very iconic projects that we have done. So this is the journey that we have made. We are doing extensive work in structural as well and architectural. And we are the first company who are working in the a very prestigious roadway project in India, where BIM has been implemented as a very first stage. So then this is our team that we are working, and we are based in India in Ahmedabad. So just then we can go with the discussion. We can start the discussion. Yes. I'll start with Mr. Ankit. You have been very instrumental in, you have worked in UK, you've been very instrumental in Singapore, Malaysia, in the Far East and in the Middle East as well. How have you seen BIM, because you have 15 years in the industry, so how have you seen BIM change the industry mission and vision? Hello.
First of all, thank you Anirban for your warm welcome, and thank you GBB Bentley. I'm audible clearly now?
Yes, you're audible.
Hello. Yeah. So first of all, thank you for your warm welcome Anirban, and thanks to GBB Ventures for arranging this seminar. I think it is really helpful.
I believe there is some internet connection problem, Mr. Ankit, at your end. Okay, I believe there is some technical lag in the connection of internet. So
hello.
Yes, Mr. Ankit, you are audible.
Hello.
Yes, you are audible.
Thanks Anirban for your warm welcome. And thanks to GBB Ventures for arranging this seminar. I think it's really a need for an AEC industry to start the digital transformation. I think digital transformation has been started a while ago. However, in India, it's taking a baby steps and it's going forward. And I'm sure that, you know, it will definitely transform the whole industry. So from my experience, I have been working since last 15 years in the AEC field, in virtual building studio 5 years ago, after returning from UK, and the aim was to transform the digital, aim was to transform the AEC industry and implement the building information modeling, AR, VR, and all the digital technologies. So that can be very helpful to the architects, engineers, clients, and owners. But I think in India, baby step is already, you know, it's in progress. And I think we are getting mature by day. There are a lot of projects which are mandatory, and BIM is mandatory by the government. And there are many territories where certain project of certain valuation or project which has certain authority, it must be done with the BIM. So BIM is must. And I think it's definitely made all of us, I mean, all the stakeholders of AEC industry very efficient.
Correct. Great. It's a great insight from your end, from your vast experience. I'll go to Saunak. Saunak has been very instrumental in Dubai. He's in UAE. So Saunak, you have worked in very prestigious projects like the architect you have been working with. It's one of the biggest in UAE. So you can tell me that how engineers are also getting benefit from BIM, because you have worked in the Dubai Expo 2020 in the Museum of Future. So can you give me some insights on that?
Yeah, so you can see, like, if you check the buildings of Jaha Hadid, you can say they're all types of buildings are unconventional type. It's not a typical block type building. All have too much curves, and the geometry is different. Correct. So for that, for mechanical, it's really difficult for mechanical engineers at all. It's really difficult to accommodate their services. So BIM is really required for the building like Biha headquarters, which we have done in Sharjah. Building like the Museum of the Future, you can check the shape. So it's like a parabolic shape and it's an ellipse. And so BIM MEP, BIM is really required to planning from the planning stage, from where the equipment will go and how the ducting will be done. So this is really required. And BIM also required in the concept stage for like for most of these iconic buildings. They actually push the mechanical guys to their limit, and they say like you have to use this much percentage of area only to design all your mechanical things. So this is for this BIM is really required. For once you have designed it and you have the proven concept, there is no chance to go back and do it again. So right. Yeah, I think, and as Ankit says that yes, in UAE also, in the other parts also, BIM is mandatory, but still there are few contractors and few consultants that they are taking it for a compliance only. Means whatever the actual benefits of the BIM, they are not concentrating on that, and they are taking it like it's a mandatory thing and we need to do it to show the government, and we are showing it for that. But BIM actually can do much more than a compliance thing. So I believe there are so many consultants, like I have worked with one of the consultants, they called GAJ, it's Gordon Erskine Johnson. They're really good from the scratch, and from the concept stage, they're actually using the BIM for any load calculation and everything. They're doing it in BIM. They're doing the BIM into everything. So this type of thing is really required.
Correct. Absolutely. With the experience that we have and with the working culture that we are having, we have seen in our everybody, all the panelists and all the participants, respected participants, we have seen that BIM is at some point of time, people are very resistant to change. That is very unfortunate in some part of the world, that people are very resistant to change. They are still back in the 80s and 90s that we will do it in AutoCAD. But now things have changed a lot. The digital transformation has taken place a lot, and that is why BIM is very much mandatory for the architects at the very beginning, at the procurement stage, at the cost control stage, at the contract stage. So this is the experience that we are having. Mr. Ankit, in US specifically, all the zones in US, they are having specific codes. Are the architects in the United States, they are following all the specific codes in all the specific locations, because they have city codes, like the code of Austin will not be the same as the code of California.
True, Anirban. So here I would like to present like this. I mean, see, for an architect, how the process starts. So architects generally involve starting from the conceptual design. So we start with the schematical design, then design development, and then construction document, right? These are the phases that we generally use in architectural practices. And as you said, there are many architects or many contractors, many experienced firms who really hesitant to accept the BIM, or who really not wants to accept the BIM fast because they have manpower who are not ready to start with the BIM. That must be the one of the reasons. And the second thing is, you know, when you accept the change, when you embrace the change, you know, generally you're afraid of the new things, that how it goes. But I would say when architects use Beam, it's really useful. So as you said, the codes are not same in all the states of United States. So when every architect's working on the schematical design, you know, on the conceptual design, they start working on the BIM models. They start with the massings, and slowly, gradually, the model has been developed to the design development phase, and the next to the construction document stage. So the one entire model, you know, develop from 0 to 100, and that's how you can save you a lot of time, whether it is in terms of drafting a sheet, whether it is in terms of creating a views, whether it is in terms of creating walking drawings. It's very easy if you start working from conceptual design to the design development or construction document in one Revit model or in one BIM. So that's really useful. I mean, this methodology is really useful, and it saves a lot of time. You can do all type of calculation codes and many other things that you can integrate. There are a lot of applications available which will help you to get that e-codes, and you can easily, you know, comply your model with all the guidelines what government requires. So I would definitely say, so in all the stages of bid, design, and build, all three stages, you can definitely use building information modeling for your project. And I would suggest, you know, everyone should embrace the change. They should start working with the small projects. And there are definite guidelines how you can embrace this kind of change across your organization. Though it's tough in the starting, but you know, it's easy in the end.
Correct. Absolutely. I agree to you. Rome was not built in a day. I can
exactly. Yeah.
I can just relate this quotation with what you have said. Absolutely. So I agree to you that the design, construct, and build, so these three parts are very much relevant to the architectural standpoint. Absolutely. And US architects are very smart. They are using the localized state codes, as you have said. Absolutely correct. Saunath, I just want to ask you, we have one very important thing in Middle East, that we are doing a big part of procurement in BIM nowadays. The big part of procurement, the making the assembly codes, taking the Omni class, assigning it to all the assets that are there. So in the time of facilities management, because the model is going to FM, any model, any BIM model is going to FM at the last. So that is the utility. How will you make it? How will you keep it for maintenance? How will you use that if something is lost or something is replaced? How will you do that? So how is this procurement thing or contracts thing or bill of quantity thing being useful for engineers in the Middle East?
Yeah, definitely. See, for the first thing, it is really important to order something. Means how much of pipe fitting you want to order. So for this, it is really important. So to answer your question, first thing I want to discuss something that for a BIM is not like only a 3D modeling. So this is a kind of thing where everyone is discussing. But the thing is 3D modeling, what we are doing, that is the most important part in the BIM. So all the information, what is the I in the BIM is the information, but there is M also, the modeling part. So the modeling is as much important as the information. Without the model, only the information is not of any use. But without the information, the only model, that is also not of any use. But only model, what we can say, there is a term called EIR. It's a employee information requirement. So we can decide it while a project starts. Means up to what level of information actually required for this project. So from there, if it is decided that we need it, this model to go up to the facility management stage. So there should be some certain criteria that should be inbuilt in the model. What whenever the draft for the modeler is doing the modeling, there should be certain criteria like whatever the information required and whatever the information is mentioned in the EIR document. So it should be there, like cost of any model, or say like a warranty period or anything that can be, but it should include in the BIM model. Maybe it is not mandatory to put the values in that. That can be done in the facility management stage.
Absolutely.
But you should have the parameters into that.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And,
correct, well taken.
When we are discussing about the Ankit's call, Ankit's reason. So yes, whenever the main problem we face as an engineer then when in a project, architect is the main, generally the consultant is from architect side, and they first do the concept, and it once the concept is done, they hire the mechanical consultant, or the things generally goes like that. But whenever the concept is done, so what we face problem, like every time architect wants a double light entry, and just after double light entry, they wants like, I need a mezzanine floor and that will have office, so it will, the usable area will be much more. So this kind of thing, I think whenever the mechanical guys also, the mechanical engineer or mechanical consultant also be a part in the core, concept, from the concept to detailed design, if the mechanical guys also can be a part of the team, then the coordination effort will be much less. And when we implement BIM, we can see and we can check if at all it is possible to put a mezzanine floor in there. Or like say like we are planning to put a mechanical floor on level 15, but if at all mechanical guys are, what they are thinking, they can push the water, or they can push the water to level up to level 15 or not. So what are their codes? It is satisfying their codes or not? So definitely while designing, we need to consider the codes for mechanical as well, not only for the architect.
Absolutely. As you correctly said, yes. As you correctly said, I just want to add what Sonak said, that absolutely, that generally the architects are the considered as the boss in construction, to be very honest. Pardon me, Mr. Ankit, if I'm telling it wrong.
No, thanks everyone. Yeah, that's right. I mean, architects are the one who acts as a driver. So they drive the car, and engineers and all other are, you know, sitting behind. They're as important as architect. Because without engineer, building can't be functional, right? Correct. But the architects are the one who really gives an aesthetical and pleasing looks, who really works hard on how it looks good, right? Correct. And the engineers are the one who makes it feel better, or who makes it working.
Correct. Mr. Ankit, what is your take on making to help architects and engineers work hand in hand using BIM? They should, for with the experience that I am having, I think that a BIM execution plan is very much mandatory for both architects and engineers. What is your take on that?
I would say yes, that is correct. I mean, there are a lot of jargons in BIM industry. So one of them is BEP. So BEP is BIM execution plan, and I think in order to start any new work, BEP is must. So you have to execute planning well, you must have that written on the code, right? So BIM execution plan is nothing but it's a document showing how we are going to execute building information modeling on this particular project. So BIM execution plan contains the stakeholders involved in the project, BIM manager involves in the project. So whether it is from the architect side, whether it is from the engineer side, whether it is from the electrical engineer side, mechanical engineer side, and all the stakeholders. And we all are tracking models one. So it is a common data environment we call. So model is commonly placed, and all the stakeholders together work on a one single model and try to update it and find out all the errors, you know, before construction happens. So that's where, you know, our job is, you know, before construction happens, we have to find out those errors. We have to save a lot of money for our builders. So, you know, the people can afford that building very well at the affordable rate, right? Without any loss of material, without any loss of goods. And that's what the BIM execution plan is. It is a simple metric. I mean, BIM execution plan shows how we are going to approach this project and how we are going to finish this project. That's it. And it has its all stakeholders, their responsibilities, their roles, their standards of meeting, their standard of collaboration. So all will be on the same page, unlike the traditional practices. But yeah, that's how the BEP works. And as I said, if you start anything, you know, all changes is hard at first, messy in the middle, and gorgeous at the end.
Absolutely. Very well said. So adding to what Mr. Ankit said, that I will relate this to one of my experiences. It's a very famous book by Dr. Albert Einstein. He's a very famous personality, that if you want to cut a tree, you need to sharpen your axe. So that is very much important. So for construction, pre-construction is very important. So if I am told that I should cut a tree in 8 hours, the first 6 hours I should have to sharpen my axe. so that in the next 2 hours I can make it time constraint, I can deliver it with time, so I can relate this thing.
Well said. I mean, BEP is the right example, relates to this. So I mean, how you can sharpen your things by planning and then you execute it, right?
Correct. Saunak, related to the engineering, related to the mechanical and electrical engineering, how you think that the future of BIM, helping architects and engineers, will help using prefabrication or fabrication? Because fabrication and prefabrication is now a big thing that is coming up in the market, and it will stay for the next 5 to 10 years, which will help very much as the precast for the architects and the fabrication models for the contractors and engineers.
Yeah, definitely. So maximum few contractors they can put a fabrication shop in a construction site. Sometimes the construction site is also not in that good location. So people are nowadays preferring fabrication. They are giving it to fabricators, the drawings and all, and it's coming on a bulk and you can just take solid. So it's always a easy process, but to make it happen, to make this process smooth, we definitely need the important for the fabricator. What kind of things need to fabricate the sequence. So, okay. And it's the information should comply in the drawing, means whatever the drawing it's offering, it's from the model. So for definitely there are several softwares like Autodesk Fabrication and Revit also can do it in the fabrication. But for fabrication, it is really required that all the elements should have certain level of information into that. Like the duct should be on a perfect length, so that the fabricator can cut the duct or can use a full metal sheet, full sheet. So there should be few information, and this is it.
Yes, absolutely correct. I agree with Saunak, because when I traveled United States, I have seen mechanical fabricators having a big prefabrication shop where they are cutting the sheet metal of the duct sheet metals in CNC machines. That Saunak, I believe you will agree, and the sheet metal sizes are at the sizes of the truck, so that the truck size, they are cutting the sheet metals, they are loading in the truck and they are taking it to construction site. Yes, so this is my experience. Yes, correct, absolutely correct.
And nowadays it's not only the duct fabrication, nowadays the whole corridor, it can be fabricated and installed in the site. When I was in Dubai also, I saw there is one company, they are fabricating the risers, they are fabricating the shafts as well.
Shafts.
Means
okay.
The total shaft, they can fabricate floor by floor.
Absolutely.
And that now the pod system comes from the toilet, there are toilet pods. So there is already everything is fabricated. You just need to install the pod and there are one outlet connection and one to that water supply connection. So you just need to install two pipes only, and other everything is done into that pod system.
Yes.
So pretty much everything is now fabricated. The contractor are moving to the fabrication part.
Absolutely. See, now how BIM is helpful, I want to just tell all the members and the panelists who are here that the total building cost, which was taking the cost and the time, because for an owner, it is highest quality, least cost and least time. This is very clear that I want the best thing in the market at the lowest price in the lowest time. So the fabrication is helping and is a paramount to this particular effect. Okay. Mr. Ankit, thing that is coming up very much now is in the digital transformation. It's a part of the digital transformation that people are going ahead of Revit in terms of Dynamo scripting, Rhino scripting, Python scripting, and GraphQL scripting. So, and these are very much useful because this is optimizing the BIM time and production of shop drawing phase as well. So what is your take on that?
Correct. I mean, nowadays a lot of enthusiastic engineers working on scripting, creating an APIs, developing an apps, right? So there are a lot of new age programs, right? Like Dynamo, you can do the Python scripting. These are the programs which helps you to create a scripts. It is similar as an Autolips, right? Which was, I think you and I had worked before in Autodesk, where there is an Autolips and you can just run that script and your all car will be placed at 45 degree, or you will get your parking lines, you know. So this is the similar kind of a program, Dynamo, that is for the 3D. You can use this kind of scripting tools and you can easier, you can make your work easier based on your needs, and that's a lot of new generation engineers are working on it because they like to mixture. I mean say digital is all about mixing and engineering with IT, right? This is what happening. Before it is like it is truly an architecture or truly an engineering. Now we have a mixture of fields available where you can be an architect, and you, if you would like to do the Python coding, you can learn the coding and you can use your script for your architectural work. Even I have seen in US there are a lot of startups which are working on the field where you can just give the space and they will say, based on FSI, they will give you the how the building builds, or what are the number of floors, what are the different kind of design option. They will give you a 100,000 options for that particular building, that how you can use the maximum FSI. So these are nowadays, you know, artificial intelligence and all these modern age tools really going to change our lives in a very different way. As like, you know, we had before 10 years, nobody was using a mobile, right? Nobody used to do the data and mobile. Now in India, we are the number two country in terms of usage of data. We are number one country in terms of lowest data, right? So data rate is lowest in the world. So number one is India. Right. And this is how we have changed ourselves in 10 years. And I would say in next 10 years, this industry is going to change a lot. Architecture and engineering industry is going to change a lot. And I'm damn sure that, you know, if whoever is not working at this speed, or whoever is not adopting the new technology, they will be at the biggest loss. I mean, they will feel the biggest loss, like the way BlackBerry is out of the market. And I can see there are a lot of big firms, architecture engineering firms in India, who are not ready to accept BIM, or who are resistant to accept the modern technologies, they will be at the loss for sure.
Absolutely. 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 Very well
and
said.
I would also like to discuss, you know, how this.
Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
So I would also like to, you know, enhance this, how these firms can be and enable, you know, BIM technology firms, or how they can embrace this kind of BIM changes in their organization. I have some formulas. I mean, there are, you know, four way methodology. So first is, you know, standard establishment. So first you have to create your standards, your BIM guidelines, your BIM workflow. You have to identify the second is that you have to identify the people in your organization who are ready to accept this change, who are ready to learn the new software, and who are ready to, you know, accept the challenge and go ahead. The third one is, you know, once you have these things ready, you can hire an BIM implementing agency. They will help you, they will do the implementation, they will do the hand holding. So in third step, it's a project implementation. So direct transfer of BIM knowledge and project experience through, you know, BIM manager services. You can directly transfer your project implementation knowledge, you can start working on project implementation, you start adopting, you know, new BIM mature working methodology. And then there is a data integration. In data integration process, you know, the BIM data, how you can integrate this data, how can utilize this data, whether it is in terms of 4D, 5D, asset management, facility management. And then last one is the hand holding and live monitoring. So, you know, like Virtual Building Studio also helps a lot of clients giving this kind of advisory. And we teach them how they can embrace this kind of changes, how they can start adopting building information modeling changes. And we help them from start to end. And even we help them for a year where, you know, we give them a handholding, live monitoring of project, and their team execute the projects in BIM and they feel confident. So I think there are a five-way full roadmap, five-way framework, which any firm can utilize and implement BIM. And there is no need to harm. I mean, there is no need to afraid of these changes, and you can start with the small projects and leverage your knowledge, you know, day by day, and you can utilize your knowledge on a bigger projects as well.
Correct. Absolutely. It was a very descriptive description of how BIM can be implemented. I'll just, in addition to what Mr. Ankit said, I'll just ask an additional question to Saunak, taking this streamline in continuation, that Saunak, how can training training and giving the architects and engineering firms training on BIM, that how shop drawing can be created very easily, how GA drawing, that is the general arrangement drawings, that can be created easily, how block wall partition drawings can be created easily. So how can this training help in educating architectural firms who have not adopted BIM, but they are very big in magnitude? How engineering firms who are a big MEP consultants, I still know many MEP consultants, they are top five in Middle East, but they have not taken BIM. They are top five in Middle East. I know firms who are top five in Middle East, MEP firms, but they have not taken BIM. So how can training on and handholding, as Mr. Ankit said, help architects and engineers get a better grasp on construction in the next 10 years?
Yeah, so in this case, what I'd like to point out again, that what Ankit said, there should be some people identified from that company who are ready to take the challenge. So for giving training to anyone, it doesn't actually work like that. Means we can arrange it, means you can give a training to anyone and for training purpose they have taken and it is not implementing. So there should be someone who implement it. And there should be some project where from the management side or from the higher management side, they make it compulsory for this project. This is a small pro job. And for this project, you have to do the BIM. So you have to make it compulsory for your team that you have to do the BIM. And you can check the what is the return of investment you are getting from BIM. So you have invested this much of amount for BIM and what is the timeline you are, means what are the return of investment are there. So I think only training will not help. But definitely there should be someone to implement it. Training, there are several training agencies. There are several implementing agencies like Virtual Building Studio also do the BIM implementation. So there are several agencies who can implement BIM in your firm, someone's firm. But it's the approach, how they are taking it, what is their mentality, it depends fully on that.
Correct. Absolutely. Now I will tell another small example that you cannot judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree. Correct? Means you cannot expect that a fish to climb a tree, so it is intelligent. You can expect a monkey to climb a tree because that is his domain. So absolutely correct what you have said, that we should identify people who are a technology enthusiast so that they can embrace the technology, they can embrace the change. And definitely for architects and engineers, it is BIM is now mandatory in most of the countries, especially in Europe and US. US it's mandatory, in Europe it's mandatory. We have seen BIM being mandatory in Saudi Arabia as well, because we have executed on behalf of Virtual Building Studios mammoth projects in Saudi Arabia, in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, governmental projects. Government in Saudi Arabia has made BIM as a mandatory field, that if there are five checklists that tick, 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 so BIM is one of them. So there is no way of escaping from BIM now. But in addition to what Saunak said, that only training will not help, Mr. Ankit, then implementing BIM, then can the companies who are in India, who are working with countries in abroad, can they send people on site, experienced people on site, on construction site, on project management side, so that there can be a mutual transfer and exchange of knowledge of BIM and of construction? Is it possible?
It's definitely possible. I mean, from Virtual Building Studio, we generally, you know, give our coordinator and manager used to go abroad on the client side. They help them to adopt the BIM standard. They help them to teach BIM. They help them to do BIM practices on the live projects. And that's how they can embrace the changes. That is possible. Even as Sonak and you said, you know, BIM is also mandatory in the smart city projects across the India. BIM is also mandatory on the different kind of infrastructure projects. And I think it is going to be mandatory on the high rises as well. As recently, you know, government has given the high rise permissions. So I think that is also going to be mandatory BIM to be used in the high rise buildings. And I think, you know, to embrace the change, it's very easy. Any architect should not be afraid of it. They should start with the small team. They can identify the good youngsters who are really aggressive and who really wants to start with the BIM, and they can create a small team. They can give them a training, hand holding, and they can start with the small projects, and that's possible. In the similar fashion, you know, the countries like Middle East, Saudi Arabia, or USA who are BIM deficit, who do not have a BIM manpower, or they cannot afford a local manpower, which are at a high rate. You know, the Indian companies or Indian outsourcing companies, they share their manpower with them for the couple of years, maybe for the 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, depends on the project timeline. So everybody goes, I mean, the good crews who are expert in BIM, they go from here to there and execute the whole project and then come back. So if an Indian companies can do it by sitting it here on the foreign projects, and I don't see it's any difficulty for any architects, running BIM in India or taking this change in their firms and start working on BIM. And I think once they start, they will definitely start getting the more and more benefits out of it.
Absolutely, and absolutely.
Yeah, this is what actually the BIM level to say, that people can be anywhere and any part of the world, and they can work collaboratively. So this is what the level two.
Level two of BIM, absolutely.
Level two of,
no, yeah. I totally agree with Sonak. I mean, level two BIM is where, multiple teams, so multiple teams can work from Singapore, Dubai, India, Malaysia, and work on a single model, and all are working on the same project. That's how the global environment works, and that's how the modern era works now, right? So we can't, I mean we can't be sitting in India, if somebody don't want to working on BIM, or somebody just want to work with the traditional methodology. I think that's not the solution, because everybody is now accepting the change. So working on a one single model, working on a one single environment or one single data, that's necessary nowadays.
Correct. Sonak, how is cloud platform helping the implementation of BIM? Suppose the architect is sitting in Europe and the general contractor is sitting in Qatar. So how the cloud platform is helping BIM to collaborate the bridge or lower the bridge, or help in bridging between architects and engineers, the cloud platform.
So whatever the cloud platform you are asking, so in BIM term, we call it CDE. So there should be one CDE. So it's a common platform.
Common data environment. Yes. Common data environment. Yes.
So it's a common platform, and everyone can have their information into there. So it can be anything. It can be a Revit server. It can be a BIM 360 cloud, but if it is a cloud, then only people from different location can access it, and for accessing it there should be obviously it was in few years back it was a problem of the internet. In few areas there was no internet connection or the connection is slow, but nowadays in worldwide almost everywhere the internet is available. So it's good, means someone is on Philippines, someone is on India, someone is on Vietnam, or someone is on USA. They can work together in a cloud platform. Cloud is required so that everyone can, in a different location, the people can work together. But the main thing is the common data environment is necessary for BIM, so that it doesn't happen that I have information and my team done as per that information, but I didn't share the information. And my separate team, who is sitting at another place, say like in Philippines, they are not following the information. So information flow should be perfect.
Correct. So
in terms, it is collaborative, and risk is shared, right? Because in the traditional method, when architects works himself, risk is not shared. But in this method, cloud method, it is collaborative, and risk is shared. Right, because engineer can see the model, architects can see the model, all can collaborate at the same time. So risk is totally shared. There is no risk on only one party, like an architect or like an engineer. Right, in traditional method, when we overlap the drawings, we found a lot of issues, we go back to them. It's a lot of wasting of work, a lot of wasting of time, a lot of wasting on drawings. So this is how you can share your risk by using cloud and modern technologies.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So it is very well taken that implementing BIM in cloud platform is helping a lot. I will just add what Sonak said in the common data environment. Ankit, in many projects across the US and UK, because you have worked extensively in UK, we have seen implementation of Newforma, Aconex, this type of platform. So how these are adding as a paramount to BIM?
See, these are the platforms which really helps collaboration in collaboration. So as you said, you know, firm is in Europe, general contractor is sitting in Qatar, designer is in Europe, and architects is in USA. Now all wants to collaborate, and they want to use this kind of tools like Econx or Newforma, which is the common data environment. What they have to do is, you know, they can hire this. So it is acting as a Dropbox, right? But it is more structured way where you can put your files, you have your versions updated. So you know which is the latest files. You can on the spot, you can give your markups, you can give your commands, and team can see it, and on the spot they can update it. And that's how, you know, it is a live work culture. Like right now we are sharing on Facebook Live. It is the live work culture. I mean, you do not need to wait until, you know, US starts next day, somebody sees and put the comments and give your answers. So how much delay that happens? Are you getting my point? So absolutely. If there is a project running in Qatar, a football stadium, and not getting a response from an architect, engineer is not able to take the decision, contractor has put a lot of money and manpower on site, he feels helpless. So this is the live system. I mean, these are the Econx, Newforma, these all are the new age tools, and a lot of multi-billion companies are investing in them just because, you know, they know that, you know, now world is more about live. The old kind of messenger is totally gone. It's dead now. Right now we are on the WhatsApp. You know, we can share the live video. Right now we can see our relatives. We can see our friends. We have a live conversation. Everybody can see us live by sitting at our home's comfort. Right? You do not need to come to the seminar to see this. You know how this beam is helpful to architects or how it's give the paradigm shift to the AEC industry. But you at the comfort of your home with the small screen in the mobile, you can see and you can actually, you know, ask your questions. So that's the new era, man. I mean, that's how it's changing.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Very, very well explained. Very well explained. So it was a very good session, actually. Means there were many things of discussion, and we had got a very good insight of the industry. Any closing statements, Sonak, to close this webinar? Any closing statements?
Okay. So I would like to just tell that BIM is not up to the pre-construction only. It is required for during the construction as well. Say there is a chiller of 10 ton and you need to lift it to a 11 floor building. So you will use a crane or you will use a helicopter. So it depends on the logistic planning. In everywhere, you can use the BIM. So BIM is, again, the same quote I will tell. BIM is not only the modeling. It's the important thing is the information, but the modeling part is also important.
Important. Great. From Mr. Ankit Sand, any closing statements?
No, I would say, I mean, when I talk to a lot of architects and engineers, they say BIM is just about the modeling. So it's not about the modeling, honestly. It's not about only 3D drafting, right? It's all about how you want to use it. So it's like a gun. If you want to use it for a good cause, you can use it. If you want to use it for a bad cause, you can use it. But it's not about only just 3D drafting. It's all about, you know, how you can utilize it on site, whether it is a pre-construction, construction stage, even in the facility management stage. So it is for the entire life cycle of the building. So stating that, you know, Indian companies are using BIM for a 3D modeling, it's not a right statement. See, people are using it for a 4D, 5D and all of the stuff. It may be possible that, you know, people are taking leverage of Indian people because the economy is a little bit lower here. The wages are a little bit lower and manpower is readily available at affordable rate. And that's why the Indian companies are doing a lot of outsourcing. But it's not about only 3D modeling. People are really putting their brains into it. And the team on the other end, on the other shore of the world, they can, you know, utilize that potential. They can take the quantity off. They can do the collaboration, coordination. And that's how it's a useful tool. Absolutely. So I totally agree with what Sonak said. Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Very good. Just a small example, and I'll give it to Suman. We were working in a very big developmental project in Saudi Arabia. It was one of the tallest buildings in the world. It's 1 kilometer vertical, Jeddah Towers. So there was a precast of 3 million Saudi riyals, and they brought the precast and they took it to the 100th floor, and due to 5 millimeter, the precast was a waste. So you can see, so you can see that without using BIM and without doing the measurements correctly, without having the visualization, if the construction is not visualized virtually, because that 3 million Saudi riyal component to take it up to the 100th floor, it took 2 hours for the elevator, definitely. And for 5 millimeter, you miss the total construction because of the difference. So this is how BIM is helpful, and I believe that in the coming future, it's a very good prospect for the industry. Over to you, Suman.
Thank you, Eban. We have a question from Hitesh.
Yes.
He says, "Hello, gentlemen. How you see BIM and AR or VR technology together? What is the upcoming industry changes that you are seeing in the future, yes, considering these together? What are the advantages and benefits that you see after implementing AR or VR in the construction and design industry?"
Okay. I believe Mr. Ankit, you will take this question.
Yeah, it's a good question. I mean, really good question. See, BIM is the modern technology for now. AR and VR is the already started implementing, and it is the next generation technology. So for example, let's say if somebody wants to buy a home, now we have to go to the site. You can go and you see the demo home, and you come back and you take your decision, right? But when you go, actually, you have to take the home on the 10th floor of the building, whether it is on the eastern side or western side of the building. It's maybe possible that eastern side is, you know, river facing or lake facing, and western side is facing the slum. So when you go on the actual site and see how the views comes from, how the views outside of your window, that's how you can judge. But AR and VR, when you create the virtual models, when you have the augmented and virtual reality, you can see the material, textures, colors, and all kind of views by sitting at the comfort of your home in your laptop. You can check what you can see outside of your window, and you can take the informed decision. So that's what I'm saying. The AR and VR is going to change the industry very well. It started right now, and I think there are a lot more to come.
Absolutely.
I hope that answer his question.
And hopefully in few days, we'll be coordinating as a mechanical engineer. We'll be coordinating same like as Iron Man does. Just like zig, zig, zig.
Zig, zig, zig. Yes, correct. Absolutely.
Yeah, you really don't need to go physically, right? You really don't need to go physically. And see, this corona has changed, you know, this pandemic has changed our mindset. The one who is not ready to sit at home, he is now ready to wear a mask and not going outside, not having outside food. So we have now changed our habits. And I think in near future, we definitely change our habits a lot. So instead of going to builders and instead of hearing their thoughts, better we would, you know, do our own research by sitting at home. Builder will give you an access. You can go and you can run through the building. You can see the material texture. And that's how things going to be very easy for us.
Okay. Yes, Suman, any more questions?
No, I'm fine. Great. Thank you everyone for sharing your insights. It was really informative. On behalf of GBB, I would like to thank Anirban, Ankit, and Sonal. We really appreciate you being here. Thanks again for joining us today. And we will see you next time.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Have a great day. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.